to talk about royal weddings. We want every bride that walks into the store to feel like Kate Middleton's going to feel on her day of her wedding.
When a bride gets married, that's kind of her moment to be a princess. So I think it's up to us to make her feel like one. In England, they have princes and princesses and queens. Well, in America, we don't have that. So on your wedding day, this is kind of your moment to be that princess.
They should all feel that way, whether they're a size 2 or whether they're a size 22. Okay.
With Randy and Dorothy's advice in mind, JB's rolling out the red carpet for her first client, VIP bride, Queen Esther.
Is Esther here?
Esther?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Empress JB.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
I don't usually walk around the selling floor like this, but I heard I had royalty at Kleinfeld today.
My name is Queen Esther, and I am the reigning Ms. Plus America.
Esther Renee Brandon.
And I'm very strong and proud in who I am. Queen Esther speaks. I brought with me my best friend, Maisha, my really close friend from college, Dana. Andrea, she's an event planner. And I brought my fiancé with me. I want him to experience as many pieces of the wedding as possible.
And you?
Vince.
The king.
Actually, yes, that's
my
last name.
Well, welcome, queen and king.
My fiancé's name is Vince King. He's a king in my heart. Queen Esther, Vince King. It's gonna be a royal wedding.
We actually met online. From the time I first saw her smile, I was like, she's royalty on many levels.
So the queen is marrying the king. And why not? They have it in England. Why can't we have a royal couple here? Even if it is just Vince and Esther.
So talk to me a little bit about the wedding.
The wedding is June 11th.
Okay.
In Naples, Florida. Hopefully on the beach.
Okay.
It's a royal wedding. So it's all about playing up him being the king and me being the queen.
Let's get started. Please have a seat.
Okay.
Now the budget is between 4 and 5.
Right, up to 5, yeah.
Any specifics as to dress that you love?
I really like dresses, of course, that has the rouging, of course, to hide a little bit of the belly. I want something that's gonna show off my curves because I am plus size, but I love them. I want to fulfill the royal wedding theme. I don't think there's gonna be a big difference between what I would wear for a pageant dress versus what I wear for a wedding dress.
How many contestants did you compete against?
There were 41 in the pageant.
Wow, wow.
For me, Miss Plus America, it means being able to communicate to all the plus size women out there that we can and we do look beautiful.
All right.
JB's got her work cut out, looking for a standout plus-size dress to please her pageant queen.
Something like this with ruching. You know, I'm gonna give it a try. Ah, Your Highness's selection. All right, I've returned.
I like.
Ah, my first pick.
I like.
JB's first poll meets the budget and the royal theme.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la.
But the sample size is small for her curvy bride.
And pushing.
See, men, this is a workout. I love it. I love it. It's pretty.
She's hoping her first dress will wow her loyal subjects.
It's pretty, but it's not you.
It's, what'd you say?
More royal.
You don't like it?
This dress is just the plain Jane. It is not her at all.
This is the understated dress.
So you don't like
about
it?
And if it was any other day but our wedding day, the very first dress would be perfect, but we were just looking for something a little bit more sparkly.
I like that your shoulders are exposed,
yeah.
and the ruching.
Well, I think this is a beautiful dress, but I want something that just has a little bit more character, a little bit more something.
I like the top of the dress, but it was understated for Queen Esther.
With only half the dress pleasing this queen, it's off with the head of dress number one.
I don't know, I like it.
Speechless, the king is.
You like this one better than the first one?
Probably for you, we'll need a little bit more sparkle. I mean, we were really looking for the wow.
I think it's too boxy. It doesn't accentuate your curves at all.
It looks like it makes her bigger.
The small beading was not enough. It just really didn't have the bling or the shine that Esther needs.
It's pretty, I like it. Unfortunately, I think it's more of what you would expect for a plus size woman.
Here we have a girl with a big tiara on her head. She wants a gown that has the bling and looks regal.
Where I have a figure.
Uh-huh, absolutely.
That can pull off maybe something a little different. I'm a big girl, I have no problem saying that for the world to know, you know, but.
You should accentuate the curves.
Absolutely.
With her first two dresses flopping royally, Queen Esther isn't so sure she'll find the one.
I am so done with wedding dress shopping.
I want to find a dress.
Queen Esther needs a regal dress that flatters her curves. And after two big misses, the pressure is on dress number three to be the jewel in the crown.
Shake it, baby.
There's just so many thoughts going through my head.
Hold on. Oh, no.
This dress, it's fabulous.
Whoa.
This dress rules for Queen Esther, but will it get the king's seal of approval?
Like it?
Actually, I'm loving the entire ensemble. And
really?
I love it. She looked amazing in that dress, like it was a royal wedding.
This gown, it has the bling that is important and looks regal, and it's form-fitting, which really highlights her curves.
I look like Miss Plus America. I got curves.
Are you wearing the crown?
I definitely have to have a crown because it's a royal wedding.
That adds a whole nother what? What? Whole nother level of fabulousness.
Just step up a little bit further. What?
This is it. That's the one. It made her cry.
It's like I'm going to get makeup on your dress.
Can you picture yourself walking down the aisle in this?
I can.
Is this the dress?
Yes. I feel wonderful. I feel beautiful. I feel sexy. I couldn't ask for more.
Esther steps into a dress that highlights her curves. And it's kind of like the reward for being true to who she is.
She looks like a queen, an empress, monarch, pharaohess, however you want to say it. She looked amazing.
I can see me royally walking down that aisle and meeting my king and living happily ever after. I feel like a queen.
While this king and queen are all set for the coronation, downstairs in fittings, full-figured bride Michelle is returning to the store to try on her dream ball gown.
My name is Michelle Vidal. I'm here for my first fitting, and with me is my father, my mother, and my sister.
Come in, everyone.
I'm really nervous that it's not gonna zip up and it's not gonna fit because I wasn't on the diet regimen that I had planned when I first purchased the dress, so I hope it fits. I'm afraid to touch it, I don't want it.
I know, it's gorgeous, look at that.
My fiancé, Greg, and I met in college through a mutual friend. We had to carpool to a friend's party, and we got lost for 4 hours. So we got to know each other, and we've been together ever since. He's just so sweet. My theme is a masquerade. Ever since I was 15, I wanted a masquerade wedding. I fell in love with the ball gown idea. My wedding's in a castle, so it kind of worked with the theme.
The style fits the wedding, but the dress may not fit the bride.
I'm a little nervous. I hope it fits. All I'm thinking was, please let it fit. Please let it fit. It fits, yay!
Oh my God, I love it. I still love it.
Wow! What do you think?
It's beautiful, it's beautiful, yeah.
It's a huge relief that the dress does fit. I look at myself in the mirror and I do feel like a princess. I'm happy and it makes me more excited for my wedding day. Okay.